that does kind of bring us, you mentioned, you know, the family blessings. That does kind of bring us to why you're here, right? Why you're with the Rangers now. I mean, you were in Seattle, you established yourself as a ball player in Seattle. You were there for how many years do you guys live in Seattle?
I have been a part of the Seattle Mariners organization for over 40 years.
Man.
I signed with them as a 17-year-old, spent 17 seasons, 7 in the minors, 10 in the big leagues. And then once I retired, I went into, you know, the broadcast booth, and I've been a part of their broadcast team for 24 years.
Yeah. And then?
And I'm only 42 years old.
But your kids have grown up.
Yeah.
And now they've started their own lives. And it turns out both of them are in North Texas. And so here you go.
Yeah. Two of the three. So my youngest and my oldest are living in Dallas area. Uh-huh. My youngest went to TCU and fell in love with Texas. She was just a baby when we were in Texas in 96. But my son loved Texas. His experiences at the ballpark in the DFW area is what brought him back to Dallas.
And Johnny Oaks loved him probably.
Oh my gosh, yes, yes. So I don't know if you know this, CJ, but back then Johnny allowed the kids to go out on the field every day for batting practice. Nice. To shag. So my son was 11 and 12 when I was a Texas Ranger, and I would pick him up at school. We'd go straight to the ballpark. He had a locker between myself and Pudge. He had his own uni.
Come on.
But he also knew the rules, right? As soon as the players come out, you disappear. So we'd get out there, and I'd throw him batting practice, and I'd hit him ground balls. Then the guys would start coming out to stretch, and he'd get off the field. And then once BP started, he was allowed to go out to the field. He shagged for our team and the visitors. He's got these great pictures of, like, with Cal Ripken and Kirby Puckett running out there in the outfield. It was just a childhood dream for him.
That is, I mean, that memory never goes away. That's incredible.
Yeah.
And how awesome for Johnny to allow the kids to do that. I know it's a little bit tougher sometimes nowadays, and rules have changed.
It'll never happen again.
Yeah, that's
amazing. It won't happen again, for sure.
Well, just become Dusty Baker's son. JT Snell had to save him at all for the World Series. That part of the game obviously has changed, which is a shame because, you know, it's like Dom Green, right? Another of ours here in the booth. Yeah, his kids grew up at the ballpark.
Yeah.
And, you know, the locker and everything. Were you ever in a position where you could?
It down a little bit, yeah. As I got older, my youngest was old enough, I was bouncing around. He probably has more memories of Japan, actually, and hitting in the cages there and bringing him on the field and playing frisbee on the field and doing all kinds of things. So probably more memories from that point. And then, yeah, they go to winter ball when I was older. And then I was trying to make that comeback as a 38 and 39-year-old. They were already in school, so you can't bring them.
They start having a life.
But, yeah, exactly. So there's definitely some memories there, no doubt.
Yeah, that's really cool. My kid and I, we watch a lot of TV. So we've always had that. It's pretty good. Special.
Yeah.
But anyway, so how many games are you going to be doing?
I'll be doing 30.
Okay. And you're starting like right away. Now we're going to Toronto. CJ and I are going to Toronto.
Mm-hmm.
And the next trip is
I think that's where I pick you guys up at. Right? Seattle, Oakland.
Yeah.
That'll be my first. I think